William Carey's contribution to India. Carey showed the power of the colloquial Bengali as an effective medium of communication. And it is Carey, more than any other European scholar missionary, who really showed to the natives of India that prose could be an effective medium. Remember, in India, the mode of learning and teaching was poetry before Carey's arrival. He chose the medium of prose for his translation, much against the traditional practice of saying profound things through the medium of poetry. And it was the necessity to preach the good news of Jesus Christ to all, not just the educated or upper classes, that made him to choose the medium of prose for the translation of the Bible. It was the very same necessity that forced these translators to base their translation on the colloquial language rather than on the formal style of the language. Moreover, the Bible itself was written mostly as prose, but these missionary translators went on a step further. Even where the Bible had in its original poems or poetic language, these translators chose to translate these pieces in ordinary colloquial language, mostly in order to achieve communicative efficiency. Carey was instrumental in translating the Bible into Marathi, Hindi, Oriya, Punjabi, Assamese, and Gujarati. While others did help, Carey was also totally involved in all these translations. Carey learned Telugu and Kannada to bring out the translations of the Bible in these languages. Later on, work on Pashto and Khasi were undertaken. On a rough estimate, we may say that Carey either worked or influenced heavily the translation of the Bible into as many as 35 languages. And in all these languages and dialects, several translations were made into the dialects of Hindi. Carey was breaking new grounds and laying the path for the development of these languages as vehicles of education. He was not personally successful in converting the Hindus and Muslims to the Christian faith in large numbers. Through the translation of the Bible and through his various other publications, he enriched modern Indian languages, encouraged prose as the preferred medium of expression for education, introduced a strategy of translation based on Sanskrit, and established procedures of translations such as teamwork. And Carey pioneered selfless work against certain social practices such as infanticide and sati. Along with his colleagues Joshua Mushman and Word, Carey had been unremitting in his endeavor to draw the attention of the government to the practice of sati. Support received in the person of Rajaram Mohan Roy brightened the prospects for the abolition of sati. Carey, with the help of the learned pundits connected with the Governor General's College in Calcutta, collected from the Hindu sacred books the passages upon which this custom was believed to have been raised. These investigations showed him that sati was a rite simply encouraged as a virtue and not enjoyed as a duty. The vernacular newspapers pioneered by the Sarambur missionaries were used to enlighten the minds of the Indians. At length, their continuous fight against this practice paved the way for the abolition of sati. Thank you.